Hey, so we're gonna solve this question. Let's read it. Adrian took a final exam and got 45 correct answers and 15 wrong answers. What was the percentage of correct answers? And we use our CUBES problem solving strategy we have on the right side. I'm gonna get started by identifying important information. Adrian took a final exam and got 45 correct answers and 15 wrong answers. What was the percentage of correct answers? They want to know percentage of correct answers. And then I'm going to do box with a circle or underline. And now I'm going to box the question. And the question is to find the percentage of correct answers. Since I have the word percentage here, and also I see percentages in my answer choices, proportion box will be very useful. Let me bring a proportion box and my anchor chart about what percentage means. So on this proportion box, I need to identify, first of all, what is my 100%. Remember how we have it in red in here? And we said that 100% is, in this case, should be the whole test or everything of the test or the total number of questions in the test. Not everyone, because it's not people. All the tests, all the questions, etc. I'm going to say probably about here, we will have 45 questions. And these are correct questions. What is the other type of questions that we can have? Exactly. Wrong questions. Wrong questions. And the wrong questions are how many? 15. Great. I'm just going to highlight those two numbers so we can see them better. But remember, I need to identify what is my 100%. So for 100%, we know is all the questions that would be 45 correct questions plus 15 wrong questions. That makes up the whole test. And total is 60 questions. Then at the very end and at the very beginning, we start with 0 questions and we're going to finish with 60 questions based on putting together the correct and the wrong questions. And then here, that's going to be our 100%. This is 0%. And what we're trying to find in this question is the percent of correct answers. The number that goes here, that is 45, this is the percentage that we don't know. We're going to identify percentages in the same color. We're going to be using orange this time. And for the numbers, we're going to be using blue. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to transfer this information into a proportion. We first did the proportion box. Now we're going to set up the proportion as it is. So I'm going to have on the left side 45 goes over the unknown value. And on the right side, I have 60 over 100%. I'm going to highlight the numbers with the same highlighters I use just so you can track me better. See, guys? Excellent. And then now from here, the next step will be to work it out, to do the operations. I'm going to do the operations here. And we know that we have to multiply the two numbers that are across and then divide by the number that we haven't used yet. So I'm going to set it up. That should be x equals 45 is doing a cross product with 100 or dividing, we put the 60. You see that, guys? And I'm going to color code so you can track me better from where did I get my numbers. 45 multiplies 100 because those are across. And then we divide by the number we haven't used yet, 60. And if you want to remember why cross product works, you can look at the questions for 7.4D question 1, 3, 5, and 7. We're going to do the multiplication and division, but I can always look at the fractions for my convenience. You notice here we are dividing 100 into 60. When we divide, the 100 is the one that we're going to divide, right? Okay, so when we divide, this number is going to get smaller or bigger? Smaller, great. How many place values are smaller? Well, if we have 160, we can reduce each value one place value. So now this division could be the same as saying 45 times 10 because we dropped this 0. Over 6 because we drop 1 0 and 1 0. Okay, and then I got this number from there, this number from here, and this number from here. See that, guys? Awesome. I'm going to continue with my operation. So we have to multiply first. So let's multiply. 45 times 10. And when we multiply by a power of 10, like 10, 100, 1000, we can focus on the number 1 and the other number, the other factor, that would be 45. But in reality, because we are multiplying by a 10, I'm gonna add a 0. So if you repeat 45 10 times, this is the value that we're gonna get. Great. Our next step will be divide. This fraction symbol means division. So that's what we're gonna do next. We're gonna divide the multiplication that we have on the top, which is 450, and we're gonna divide by the 6. And I'm gonna say 6 times what gets me 4? That's not gonna work. 4 is smaller than 6, so it's not working. I need to get 2 digits instead. Can you use the multiplication chart we created in the very first video? Okay, so 6 times what will be 45? 7 is the closest? Okay, 6 times 7 is 42. I can regroup or I can just look at the whole number and see if I can do that. Can I subtract 42 from 45? What is 45 minus 42? Very correct, that's gonna be a 3. We bring down our 0. Great. And then 6 times what gets me 30? That's gonna be 5. 6 times 5 is 30. So this is gonna be remainders 0. That will be the remainder. Okay, so that means that the percentage goes here, it's 75%. I'm gonna check correctly my question to make sure that's what they want. What was the percentage of correct answers? It does make sense because 45 is close to 60, which is 100%. 75 sounds reasonable. And I'm gonna put a cloud around. I'm gonna highlight my answer. And you guys did a great job. Thank you.